everyone. It's Michael Dougal with RE/MAX Premier. I appreciate you tuning in to watch this short message where I'm going to update you on the Greater Toronto Area and the real estate market. Before we begin, don't forget to check out my listings. I have 8 on the market right now. If you're looking to buy, you can contact me if you have any questions about those properties. And I also have some pocket listings. Some are single family residential, some are investment properties. So let me know if you're looking to buy, and as well, if you're considering selling, I'd love to apply for the job. Call me. 416-671-5218. Let's get right into it. I'm shooting this video August the 7th, 2019, and I'm really excited because we now have all the statistics for July 2019. So I'm gonna take you through just and really guide you as to what's happened during this year. I'm gonna specifically go over the change between June to July 2019 and as well do an analysis over what's happened over the past 12 months. Now, one of the major advantages of being an agent is we can really see what's happening in the market before everybody else hears about it. So before the media starts talking about it. And the average price has dropped by 3% since June to July 2019. And I definitely have observed it. It was the middle of June towards the end of June 2019 where I was telling a lot of my clients that the market's slowing down a bit, the average property is getting less showings, they're getting less offers, there's less buyers in the market, and we could be chasing a downward trending market. And now we have all the statistics as evidence, and we can see here that the average price during July 2019 was $806,755. And then if we look at June 2019, we can see that the average price was $832,703. So that's pretty significant. And this encompasses all of the GTA and all home types. So that encompasses townhouses, condo apartments, semi-detached and detached homes. As far as the days on market is concerned, and this is good because it's also like a good barometer as far as the market and if we're in a buyer's market or a seller's market, the average days on market in June was 21 days and in July it was 23 days. The average list price to sales price ratio, that hasn't changed much. We're still at 99%, although the biggest difference is that now there are very few areas which have properties selling over asking. Whereas the first 6 months of the year, we really saw properties like below 800,000, they were selling over asking. Condo apartments, townhouses sometimes as well, they were selling over asking. During June, there in Milton, the properties were selling at 103% of its asking price. Toronto West, so Etobicoke, North Etobicoke, South Etobicoke, and then Toronto East, they were selling at 103% of their asking price. Whereas now in this market, the only area that has been selling over its asking price is Toronto East. So that's east of Victoria Park and all of pretty much Scarborough up to Pickering. So that is the strongest market right now. The average home is selling at 101% of its asking price in an average of only 18 days on the market. So if you're in Scarborough, you've got a property specifically like a detached, it is a great time to sell and cash out. As far as the market goes on a year-by-year basis, fortunately, most home types are up in value with the exception of detached homes. Detached homes, that bracket of property, they're actually down by 0.9%, whereas semi-detached homes, they're up by 5.3%. Townhouses, they're up by 4.3%. And condo apartments are up by 6.7%. That's on a year-by-year basis. The months of inventory, this as well is a really good measure of the health of the market. It's only, it's slightly changed. It was at 2.5 during June and now it's at 2.4. Although the number one reason for this and that it is lower is because there just have been less listings. Right now there's only 17,938 active listings, whereas in June there were 19,655 active listings. So for you, if you're considering selling, this could be a good time to put your property on the market just to beat out on the competitor listings that may be coming up. We typically notice that during the end of August, beginning of September, when people come back from vacation and they want to get into the market, they put their home up for sale. So if you're in a subdivision where there's not a lot of listings, it's a great time to put your property on the market. Call me, we can go over how much you can get realistically for your home. We can go over the market and what I would do as far as game plan to get you top dollar. I'd be happy to do that. The builders of new construction homes, they were really increasing their prices. As the prices went up during the first 6 months of the year, the builders, I mean, some of the condos downtown, they're selling for over $1,000 per square foot. So now, fortunately, since this happened, who knows, maybe the builders will start charging less. So it's a great time to buy overall. Interest rates are still low. If you have questions about this or anything at all, call me. I'd love to help. It's Michael Duggal with RE/MAX Premier. Don't forget to share this video with anyone you know that may find the information helpful. If you got this by email, just forward them the email. If you just discovered the YouTube link, then copy and paste the link on YouTube. I do reply to all comments and I love the feedback. Thank you so much for your support. Call me if you're thinking of buying or selling. My customers get excellent service. Hope you guys found that helpful, and I'll look forward to seeing you all next time.